We've all seen things that move fast. What makes it possible for us to see them, or indeed see anything at all, is light. Light travels at speeds that are hard to imagine. Light from the sun travels through space at around 300,000 kilometers per second. Here's another way of looking at it. If you traveled that fast, you could go around Earth's equator 7.5 times in 1 second. Space isn't the only thing light travels through. On Earth, it can pass through a range of natural and artificial transparent and translucent materials, like the atmosphere, clouds, water, clear glass, plastic, cooking oil, or your sunglasses. The speed of light varies according to the medium or material it passes through. For example, it decreases when light enters our atmosphere. Unlike space, which is a vacuum, light collides with countless billions of particles in the atmosphere, causing it to slow down. When light travels through water, it slows considerably to around 225,000 kilometers per second, which is about 25% slower than its speed through space. Light travels as waves. When light travels from one medium into another, its speed changes, causing it to bend. This bending of waves is known as refraction. Refraction also occurs with other types of waves, like sound and water waves in the ocean. Refraction of light can be simply demonstrated. When an object is placed into a glass of water, it appears to bend. That's because the light's speed changes when it passes from the atmosphere into the water. You can also see the bending of light by looking through the side of a jar of pickles. Refraction makes the contents appear bigger than they are. Refraction of light allows us to see things. The lens and cornea of our eyes refract light onto the retina, where an image is formed and sent via the optic nerve to our brain. There is a double bending of light in the process, which turns the image upside down. This is corrected by the brain. We use the refraction of light in many ways. For example, it helps anyone who wears glasses or contact lenses to see more clearly. These lenses are made of a plastic that is designed to bend light in certain ways. Lenses are important in many applications. Microscopes and refracting telescopes use lenses. Microscopes have at least two convex lenses that refract light, so an enlarged image of a translucent specimen or object can be seen. Refracting telescopes also use convex lenses, but they are designed to bend the light so that enlarged images of distant objects can be seen, like stars, or things closer to home, like ships at sea. Light travels in waves. To be more specific, transverse waves. If you hold a slinky in the air and move your hand up and down, it forms a transverse wave. It does the same on the floor when your hand moves from side to side. Light travels in vertical and horizontal transverse waves, and any angle in between. Polarizing filters, like those used in polarized sunglasses, only allow light waves through that are traveling in one plane. They are made of material that has all its molecules lined up in the same direction. Only light waves aligned in the same direction can get through. The effect is a decreased intensity of light. Unpolarized light appears like this to our eyes, whereas polarized light appears like this. Wearing polarized sunglasses on a sunny day helps reduce the glare. It's especially noticeable around water or other surfaces that reflect sunlight. Polarized light has a range of applications in science and industry. Polarized microscopes, LCDs, photography, and testing plastics. It's also used in the glasses for viewing 3D movies. Humans produce filters to polarize light, but some animals, like ants, bees, wasps, and crabs, have polarizing filters in their eyes. Different properties of light, like refraction and polarization, are constantly seen in nature. They're also used in many of the things around us that impact not only the way we see things, but many other aspects of our lives as well.
If you liked this video, you can find it and so many more at ClickView.net. Sign up for free today.